just that they need enough space, Brent, to do it. That's the strategy here.
Sometimes it's not just about the space, Kevin, but it's about the timing of the cuts. When a guy has a post-up opportunity, if the defense is looking at that post-up player, if you move at the right time, you can really create some incredible space for that guy, not only to score, but to sometimes find cutters who sneak behind the eyes of the defense.
All fueled up and ready to go. Brought to you by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. Setting the floor for the Bucks. On the perimeter, it's Middleton and Giannis. Parker and Henson, the duo inside. And it's Brogdon in at the one spot. Milwaukee on D. Coming off that win against the Nets.
And you know what? Up against a weak defense, they were allowed to do pretty much whatever they want.
What I like, though, besides that, is that they just didn't settle for it, because weak defenses, you could take bad shots. That's not what they did here tonight.
Well, yeah, how about the purpose with which he's crashing the backboards right now? Some hard-earned second-chance points.
Bulls shooting their first free throw this game.
And you look at the Bucks in this roster, and the one constant at every position, win. Great height and wingspan. Giannis and Maker, just to name a few.
Now, two areas where Giannis is improving is his poise and his awareness. That time he finds the open man.
To the left wing. Here's Mwaba. He had 10 points in the win against the Lakers. There's a good screen. Four on the clock. And the foul on John Henson. That's foul number two for him.
A little over-aggressive. He's got to dial it back if he wants to stay on the floor. Two fouls in the first. Tough to overcome.
Zeller is checked in for Henson. Now, here's Valentine. And Markkanen throws it down.
And how about the hops there by Markkanen? He knows not many guys can block that shot. Good at getting that deep post position.
And Middleton kicks to Zeller. Back to Middleton. Over Valentine. Will not go. This is off the front iron. The Bulls have gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Markkanen kicks to Lopez. And stolen by Zeller. Here's Brogdon. The shot will not fall. And it's Chicago the other way. Their last game, a win against the Lakers, looking to carry it into this one.
Yeah, that was a fun one to watch. Love seeing the desire that comes through when a team knows they have to turn it up to pull off the comeback.
Antetokounmpo passes to Brogdon. He dishes it to Middleton, puts it up from 17, and he buries that one, drilling the rim on the way down.
Middleton only takes a second to get that shot off. Such a good catch-and-shoot game.
If you're just tuning in, we played about 2.5 minutes here in the first. Dunn kicks to Lopez. On the dunk by Lopez.
Artful passing on that play, showing a real desire to set up the teammate.
Inside, stolen by Markkanen. Valentine with it. Lopez a screen. Now, Valentine to the paint. And Lopez throws it down.
A finish as you're ever going to see out of this guy.
Well, gee, it adds now to their lead in spectacular fashion.
And to me, this is why they're winning, guys. Unlikely players stepping up huge against a defense that's really nowhere to be found.
Now here's Zeller, currently averaging almost 6 points a game. Just under 3.5 minutes gone here in the first quarter. And here is Valentine. They set the screen. Here's Lopez. From outside, off the mark.
And you know what? You can't get a better screen. Frees him up beautifully, but he just fails to capitalize.
Oh, man, he'd love to have that one back. He just does everything right. But doesn't get the finish.
Brogdon with it. Now defended by Markkanen. Down it echoes. Nice one there from Antetokounmpo.
Got to try to body Giannis up and knock him off balance because he's very consistent on the interior.
And the first timeout of the game call for Chicago.
After the knee injury that Parker suffered as a rookie, you just really hoped all that explosiveness would come back. It did, in a big way. Unfortunately, it had another tear of the ACL, which started the process over again. But given his track record, I think he'll be back to form.
Entirely new group.
Portis is checked in for Lopez.
Vonleh comes in for Markkanen. Justin Holliday is checked in for David Mwamba. And it's Jaren Grant in for Dunn. Big group substitution here for Milwaukee. Williams is checked in for Parker. Tony Snell comes in for Antetokounmpo. Shabazz Muhammad's checked in for Chris Middleton. And it's Jennings in for Malcolm Brogdon. Now here is Holliday. Down low, Vonleh. And the dunk by Vonleh.
Not an explosive leaper. Vonleh does have the length to get to the rim, and you just love to see that aggressiveness there.
Jennings wide open. No good with the triple. The Bulls leading by five. Bulls moving the ball around. The shot by Vonleh no good.
I'm shocked that didn't turn into 3 points. I mean, he makes you pay on those nearly every time.
Fast break. Here we go. As Portis throws down the breakaway jam.
He has got careless with the ball there, and the turnover leads to the big stuff.
Once he came upright with the steal, he went straight on the attack.
A terrific anticipation using the hands. How are you not protecting the basketball in that situation?
And Milwaukee has possession after the Bulls pick up two. Find the shoot. Jennings gets to Williams, and it's Williams with the jam.
And that's such solid, fundamental basketball on display right there.
You talk about it all the time, Greg. Yeah, great use of the pick to set up the dunk.
That's a play that only works by practicing over and over and having a great rhythm with your teammate. You can see the timing there.
Great positioning on the putback.
Just no resistance on the inside. That's their fifth consecutive make in the paint.
Jennings for three. They get the rebound. Second chance effort. And Zeller with the lay-in. Zeller's got his first basket.
Soft touch on the lay-in. Not everyone has that.
There's 18 seconds left in the first quarter. Now, here's Grant. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. There's Portis, and he slams it one-handed.
And he can do a lot more damage to the rim than that when he wants.
Oh, you're right.
Just off trail.
Attacking the rim in more than one way, and with that kind of success, you feel like the defense is going to make the adjustment, then you start playing inside out.
The Bulls leading by seven. Here's Grant. They've got Portis. Vonleh is out there with Valentine. And there's Grant, and it's Holliday, and at the shooting guard. So that's the five in the game for Chicago. to the paint is Conway, and he could not get that one to go. A lot of contact, and he'll go to the line for two. Brent, all things being equal, do you like the idea of sending everyone to the defensive glass to avoid giving away second-chance points, or do you like leaking a guy or two out in transition, hoping for the best?
I don't think the leak out is a good idea at all, Kevin. You've got to have five guys attentive to any possession. Most coaches in the NBA will tell you that a possession is not a stop until you collect the defensive rebound.
Free throw good, Vonleh.
A five-star recruit coming out of high school. Vonleh was the ninth overall pick in that highly anticipated draft class of 2012.
He hits one and misses one, each at the line. Bucks trail by eight. There's Jennings with the three, sinks the three-pointer. Jennings has got himself on the board with three there.
And guarding him on the perimeter isn't a priority for them right now, but if this continues, it will be.
Grant the pass to Portis. Holiday left side. Pass to Vonleh. Here's the screen. The Bulls need to get a shot off here. The shot by Valentine, no good.
That is some tough defense there against one of the better finishers in our game.
Jennings dishes to Muhammad. Up again. It's rebounded by Portis. Chicago leading by five. And Holiday kicks to Grant. Here's Portis. Knocks down the three ball. Portis has got nine.
Love to see it when he pulls up from the outside. A big guy with tremendous range is a prized commodity in today's NBA.
Jennings passes to Muhammad. Over Holiday. Muhammad, no one.
I still love the shot selection. The defense wasn't really a factor. You need to be more aggressive guarding the mid-range.
Grant with the ball. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change.
Oh, taking it to the rack with power.
Hammering down the two-hand slam. Bucks trail by 10. And Milwaukee calls their first time out of the game. Last time they met was in Milwaukee.
And you know what? Up against a weak defense, they were allowed to do pretty much whatever they wanted.
What I like, though, besides that, is that they just didn't settle for it, because weak defenses, you could take bad shots. That's not what they did here tonight.
And one thing they'll discuss are their defensive rotations. The other is in the matchup.
We're seeing very little help defense on the inside. And even when there is help, it's been ineffective.
Entirely new grouper. Lopez is checked in for Portis. Markkanen comes in for Noah Vonleh. David Mwaba is checked in for Denzel Valentine. And it's done in for Grant. Big group substitution here for Milwaukee. Parker's checked in for Williams. Giannis Antetokounmpo comes in for Tony Snell. Chris Middleton's checked in for Muhammad. And Malcolm Brogdon subbed in for Brandon Jennings. And Holiday kicks to Markkanen. Here's Lopez. Another three for Chicago.
Oh, great ball movement there.
Bucks trail by 13. Antetokounmpo dishes to Henson. They need this. That one's off. He's now 1 for 2.
A slight rebound advantage for them. One more column in their favor, and it's all adding up.
Mwaba passes to Lopez. Clock at 4. Rebounded by the Bucks. And a look at John Henson, the Tar Heel product, very measured in his play. Never does much to hurt you when he's out on the floor.
John Henson's out there for two reasons: rebound the basketball and be a rim protector. He uses those incredibly long arms to bother shooters, and as long as the perimeter defense is shuffling guys towards John Henson's way, he can have a huge effect on the ballgame for the minutes he's in.
And you got to give him credit there. Great effort to contest that shot.
Well, I love the fact that they put the security system on their house, protecting the paint there.
Out of bounds, Milwaukee takes possession.
And let's check out some stats. Here are the numbers for Jabari Parker. Fourth in field goal percentage and he's right up there in the top 20 in scoring. Certainly a force to be reckoned with offensively.
And yeah, he's such an efficient scorer, understands the offense, moves without the ball so well. That's why he's top 5 in field goal percentage. And just over 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Jabari Parker. That is his first foul of the game.
Yeah, really good defensive play to cut him off there and square up.
Tyler Zeller's checked in for Milwaukee. Chicago leading by 11, stolen by Middleton. Holiday, he's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. Lopez a screen. Jabari Parker comes up with the rebound. For Milwaukee, they've gone only 2 of 7 from the field since the second quarter got underway. Lopez with the ball. And Zeller picks him up defensively. Stolen by Brogdon. Here's the break. For the finish. The post-to-post dunk.
And that's a momentum shifter. A steal leading straight to the basket.
And the replay is courtesy of Under Armour. Unleash chaos. There's a great sequence from the steal all the way to the finish at the other end. Dunn kicks to Nwaba. Lopez a screen. Passes it to Dunn from outside the arc. That one doesn't drop. Now the Bucks take it the other way. And here's Middleton. A 17-point game for him in the win against Brooklyn.
Well, I think he was especially impressive on the glass. The defense had no idea what to do with him.
Again and again, they're dissecting the defense and creating those high-percentage looks from inside.
Down low, here's Markkanen, and he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. It's on Jabari Parker.
And Markkanen is showing the aggressiveness you like to see in a guy with his skill set. Somebody who doesn't lack confidence when he shoots the ball.
This is his first free throw of the game. And the first one at the line is good. Some changes for Chicago. Bobby Portis comes in for Robin Lopez. And it's Grant in for Justin Holiday.
Yeah, nice job of drawing the contact and creating opportunities at the line.
Antetokounmpo gets to Middleton. He feeds it to Zeller. Middleton outside for a three. Brogdon. Good, and the assist goes to Middleton. Brogdon's got 5.
And good passing, setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
Grant outside. To the middle. Here's Portis. And he makes no mistake on the slam dunk.
Now, how about breaking out the Statue of Liberty on that dunk?
A nice way to pad that lead a little more. You're right. Here's Antetokounmpo. He had a 21-point outing in their last game against Brooklyn. Here's Brogdon. 5 points in the game. A shot by Williams, no good. With one on the clock. No shot, one. And the first half is now in the books. Rolls out front, up by 8. And we'll be back right after halftime to get the third quarter underway.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, everybody. Ernie Johnson here, along with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Time to check out the first half of action. Chicago holding the upper hand after the first two quarters. They have an 8-point lead. How about you, Shaq? What did you think about Chicago?
Well, the offense is running on all cylinders. Guys are focused, executing, not playing outside of themselves. That's why their shooting percentage was so high. You know, Larry. In the stratosphere. Anyway, they're mixing things up, which keeps the defense scrambling.
Kenny, what was your takeaway on Milwaukee?
They're not getting to the line or putting enough pressure on the defense. They have to be much more aggressive pushing the basketball, going hard to the rack. Because if you want the ref to make a call, put them in the position to make a judgment call. If you're not creating opportunities for contact, you have no chance of picking up points at the line.
And time now to...
And the third quarter about ready to get underway. Chicago leading by eight on the court for the Bucks. Giannis and Parker, the explosive forward pair. Ogden and Middleton are the guard tandem, and it's Henson in at the five down low.
No doubt disappointed with that one. He'd love to have that one back.
Yeah, I put that play on repeat. The setup was perfect. Just need a better result next time.
Valentine kicks to Lopez. And the foul on John Henson. That's his fourth foul at the contest. Hey, Brent, you made the NBA playoffs in your second year. Talk about the mental preparation that goes into one's first postseason as a player.
I think it's always a special time, Kevin, just because of the unknown factor. And at that time, it was the Clippers, my second season, a team that was very young and inexperienced. And so it was all fresh and new. And the biggest challenge for any coach in that sort of predicament is to make sure that players are on task and focused. We certainly were not. The Utah Jazz took care of us, and that's because of one John Stockton and Karl Malone.
Antetokounmpo dishes to Henson. The putback, he hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. Five buckets in a row from the paint.
And here in the second half of play, we're just over a minute in. Dunn passes to Markkanen. Sinks the triple. Markkanen's got 7 points.
And I tell you what, Markkanen has already mastered the art of the bank shot. Loves getting up there and knocking that one down. You have got to be in his space if you want to disrupt his rhythm.
The Bulls leading by 9. 90 seconds now into the second half.
And he wasn't about to do anything that would get him in trouble there.
Nope, up and in with a one-hand finish, the most basic possible. Timeout called, the Bucks. Assess what parts of the floor the attempts have been coming from as we look at the shot chart for the Bucks.
And they've been doing a great job of getting into the paint and scoring inside. The defense allowing them easy access to the rim, and boy, are they taking advantage.
Bucks trail by 11. Ogden kicks to Parker. And Middleton now a job the key. And it's good on the assist by Parker. 6 points for Chris Middleton.
That's a good read by Jabari, a solid passer. He knew he could reward a teammate that time.
Dunn dishes to Lopez. Shot clock at 5 to the inside. It's deflected. Valentine kicks to Markkanen. And again, it's the Bulls from deep.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
Inside, Henson, and he drops in the layup off the glass.
This is where he should operate. Henson has developed his skills has limited range.
Malcolm Brogdon, a second-round pick out of the University of Virginia. What a fine break he has been, and you love that he can fill in at either guard spot.
And you get the feeling Brogdon was overlooked for being a four-year player in college. Has the passing and vision of a point guard. Scores well enough from inside and out to play off the ball as well.
Parker outside. They set the pick. Parker double team. Back to Brogdon. Nice ball movement by Milwaukee. Ends with the ball out of bounds. Henson touched it last. And now, let's bring up the 2K leaderboard to see which teams over the last month have been best at scoring points off turnovers. The Bulls third.
Yeah, I mean, their defense has been really good, and it's led to a lot of easy opportunities on offense. Creating points off turnovers has been key.
Here's what Chicago's going with right now. Justin Holiday comes in for David Mwamba, and it's Jaren Grant in for Chris Dunn. Grant the pass to Markkanen. To the paint, Parker with the steal. Under 2.5 minutes off the clock now here in the third, and he's fouled on the shot. One free throw coming up.
How about that one? Able to maintain control and finish the play.
Some changes for Chicago. Portis is checked in for Lopez, and Vonleh subbed in for Markkanen. Milwaukee also making some changes. Tyler Zeller's checked in for John Henson. Williams comes in for Jabari Parker, and it's Muhammad in for Chris Middleton. Holiday with it. He's been patient so far, nothing yet on the scoreboard.
And just tags a few more points onto their lead with the tomahawk.
Ah, that's bringing it down hard. Ogden kicks to Zeller over Vonleh. Got that one. The Bulls' lead has been cut down to 9 in the bucket from Tyler Zeller.
And that's an old school move right there. A good one, too, the fadeaway.
There's the screen. Dish now to Vonleh. Back to Grant. We've got 1:48 left in the third. Lock at 6. And Holiday kicks to Portis. Nice pass. Nice catch and a resounding dunk.
And the one-hand slam just looks so pretty when it's in his hand and he's the one doing the slam.
Agreed. He is smooth as silk, even on a power finish. Muhammad against Holiday. Out that one. The Bulls' lead has been cut down now to just 9 in the bucket for Muhammad. .116 left to play in the third. Now Grant. To the middle. And it's Vonleh slamming it down.
When we talk so much about accurate shooting, sometimes accurate passing can lead to great shooting. You saw it there.
That Unleash Chaos Under Armour replay really giving us a good look at the action. There's the foul. It'll go on Jaren Grant. That'll be his second foul of the game. And here is Brogdon. He has 5. 6 on the shot clock. Here's the teardrop.
Well, you notice the length there from Vonleh, allowing him to get that shot block.
Out of bounds. Milwaukee takes possession.
Is just a careless turnover. You've got to be smarter in those exchanges.
.34 seconds left in the third quarter. Brogdon with it. Now defended by Grant. Here's Muhammad. Offensive rebound. Chicago leading by 11. Here's Portis. He's got 15. And here at the end of the third quarter, it's a double-digit ball game. Bulls lead by 11. And we'll have the start of a fourth quarter for you as soon as we get back from this short break. Thank you. And we're getting underway here in the fourth quarter. The scoreboard tells the story in this matchup, but we'll see how much things change up here. Bucks trail by 11. Lays out there with Portis. Then there's Grant, and it's Mwamba in at the shooting guard position. So that's the five in the game for Chicago. Here's on to Tecumbo. That one falls. On to Tecumbo has got the first basket as we get going in the fourth for Milwaukee. To the inside. And Bonley has it in the corner. Oh, good on the triple. And for Milwaukee, they're shooting at 50% in a decent group. Three-pointers, Snell, it's all in by the Bulls. Portis has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Here's Mwamba. Here's Vonleh. Here's Holiday. They swipe it. Right side, out of the Kumbo. Zeller. Chicago grabs the miss. Vonleh's got three rebounds so far in the game. There's the pick. And Holiday kicks to Portis. Yes, and it's Holiday with the assist that time. Holiday's got four assists in the game. Bucks trail by 11. And we have so many great spot-up shooters in this league, but from what you've seen, who are some of the best shooters off the dribble?
First guy I think about, Kevin, is Kevin. It's Durant, though, not you. I know you were a great shooter.
I was a good shooter.
But Kevin Durant's efficiency after transferring over from OKC to Golden State, it's really remarkable how much he's learned to play without the basketball, yet still having a career-efficient year. Him off the dribble is dangerous for anybody.
Timeout called, the Bucks. Hey, Brent, when you look at the All-Star balloting, it's amazing how many worthy point guards have to be left off the roster. How'd the league end up with so many great players at that position all at once? It's an amazing story.
It has been an incredible prop. I mean, really, the golden era of point guards. And the one guy who I feel really badly for over the course, certainly, of the last five or six seasons is one Mike Conley. Any coach in the league would take Mike Conley at the drop of a hat, yet he's dealing with, over the course of his career, Russell Westbrook, James Harden, Tony Parker, Steve Nash, Chauncey Billups, Chris Paul. Should I go on, Kevin? It is a very, very tough position.
Those names, it says it all.
And he's probably looking at some matchups on the floor he'd like to take advantage of.
I'm interested in what he's seeing and then what kind of play they run coming out of this timeout.
So for the Bulls. Robin Lopez has checked in for Vonleh. Markkanen comes in for Justin Holiday, and it's done in for Jaren Grant. Milwaukee also making some changes. Hansen's checked in for Zeller. Jabari Parker comes in for Marvin Williams, and Middleton subbed in for Tony Snell. Eric got an update here, so let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline.
Well, during that last timeout, Kevin, I got a chance to hear what the head coach of the Bucks said to his team. No surprise, he was not happy with the turnovers. He told them, "We are giving this one away, guys. We've got to be more careful with the ball, play within the offense, and get good open shots." Kevin?
And last season, Giannis truly making the leap to superstar in the NBA. Brent was recognized by the fans, as well as he was voted in as a starter for the All-Star game in New Orleans.
And I love the point that Giannis made last year with regards to that All-Star voting, Kevin. He said he would have gotten more votes if people knew how to spell his name correctly. I still get it wrong.
Parker outside. Henson with the screen. And that one's good. Parker.
Well, that's a beauty from Parker there, making hard shots look incredibly easy.
Now, here's Dunn. He's guarded by Brogdon. Portis can't get it to go. Bucks trail by 12. And up the court come the Bucks on the break. And the bucket counts. 3-point chance here.
How about that? Parker taking the contact and still connecting on the tough field goal attempt. That's some strength.
And last season, Jabari Parker added a consistent three-pointer to his tool set as a scorer.
When you think about the first few games, averaging about 13-7 and jumped it up to 19, and then all of a sudden, you get to December, and he's averaging over 20 a game. So for Jabari to have that kind of consistency and that kind of improvement and gain his confidence, he's got to feel good that if he gets back to health, he can still do damage in the NBA.
Now, here's Dunn. Lopez outside. 6 to shoot. Inside, Markkanen, and Markkanen throws it down.
A one-man show offensively, and that's almost always good news for his team.
Brogdon with it. Dishes it to Middleton. Henson with the screen. Here's on to Tecumbo. Uses the glass to finish the layup. On to Tecumbo. He's got 5 points now this quarter.
Giannis extending past the defense on the inside. Looks like his arms just don't end.
Here's Portis. Lopez a screen. Here's Portis on the arc. Lopez, no up.
Close to making the defense pay for the last coverage.
The shot's good from Henson.
Well, that's some good O there. Always like to see them getting those interior looks.
The Bulls leading by 10. There's a minute 40 left in the game. Dunn kicks to Markkanen. And there's the pass to Lopez. And so the ball goes out of bounds. Lopez takes it back. Denzel Valentine is checked in for Bobby Portis. Timeout called, the Bucks. They're behind by 10. We've got 1:28 left in the fourth quarter of this one. And now, a moment to take a look at our Jordan player of the game.
And in terms of his shooting, this has been one of the more accurate performances you've ever seen. I mean, he's been in constant motion, creating a lot of good looks for himself. But still, even when you're wide open, you expect to miss some of the time. You know, that has not been the case here tonight. This guy has made everything.
He's playing up to his full potential tonight. He's been playing to the crowd, too. He loves being the star attraction, even if it doesn't happen on a regular basis. Gets it down to single digits.
The mindset right now is pretty strong. Superb at staying aggressive, but right now stringing some plays together.
Here's Markkanen. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Markkanen's got 5 points in the quarter.
And you can see the play calling this half. Another one from distance.
No question. It looks like they've rented out room along the perimeter in this ball game, and they're likely to keep doing this until the defense makes an adjustment.
And the double up out of Tecumbo. 5 on the clock. Pass to Parker. Shoots over Markkanen. Here's Brogdon. Puts it down to Middleton. And a great assist by Brogdon as that one goes in.
And don't want to leave Middleton from that area. His mid-range game is on fire, draining those shots off him.
Here's Dunn. Here's Lopez out to the right wing. Tough sequence there. They just couldn't get it to fall. Here's Milwaukee now. 9-point game. There's a 4-second difference from the shot clock to the game clock. Guys, they can just sit on the ball here if they want to.
They have earned this win.
The bounds, Bulls ball, Chicago keeps possession.
This active defensively here being extremely disruptive.
Like the aggressiveness and a great effort just to get a hand on it.
Seconds left in the fourth quarter. Holiday, the pass to Felicio. And he makes it look easy, dunking it hard with one hand.
And they've earned this one, showing an ability to dominate in front of their home crowd.
Yeah, tick-tock and much time on the clock. A double-digit lead and coming up roses.
And so Chicago takes this one and by a big margin. Some good moments throughout this one, but they have the clear advantage down the stretch.
Yeah, I mean, I love the way they executed on both ends of the floor, completely under control for the vast majority of the game. And whenever there was a misstep, they just didn't allow it to fester. And that's why they're going to walk away with the win.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. So for David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, Brett Berry, and the whole 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for being with us. We'll see you next time. Have a great evening.